Remember when you got called a conspiracy theorist when talking about FEMA camps and the closed down Walmart centers that could possibly be a future detention center type of facility, maybe? Well, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to add somebody to the list of conspiracy theorists. And a very noble act, I think, from Senator Merkley, where he went to the... Okay. Let me show this article to you real quick. Well, you just look at it. Inside Casa Padre, the converted Walmart, where the U.S. is holding nearly 1,500 migrants. Oh, yeah. Read all about it. CBS News, New York Times, Washington Post. Casa Padre, the converted Walmart. These are not kids kept in cages inside a Texas shelter for immigrants. What about... courts. Courts says a prison or a summer camp. Widely different spins on Casa Padre. So, I certainly haven't been there. I haven't seen what it looks like on the inside. I will say this. When watching Senator Jeff Merkley go there and attempt to get footage on the inside, you can see that Walmart center there. This is on Facebook Live. He did this Facebook Live. This was June 3rd at 5:30 p.m. And he gets surrounded by police officers. And, you know, I'm thinking to myself, just in my mind, the first thing that came to my mind when looking at this and watching him be surrounded by police officers saying he can't go inside of that facility, I think seems like kind of a prison state to me. And it's fascinating to think of what they could do with all of these different facilities that have been decommissioned, or I shouldn't even say decommissioned, that have just been closed down for plumbing purposes or whatever else. But this is the senator right here, Senator Jeff Merkley of Oregon. And I've never heard of him before, so what a great way to get coverage too, right? I mean, here you go. You'll get some media coverage that way. Isn't it great you can take media into the palm of your hand? I mean, it doesn't take much anymore to stream around the world with incredible platforms. So check this out. Look at this. You like my sunglasses? Oh, yeah. I just got them. So, finally night. Okay, I'm sorry. I digress. All right. So, I want to share with you a little bit of this article from New York Times. And before I do, I also wanted to bring up Virtual Shield. They're offering awesome deals right now for Leak Project listeners. The most sophisticated and easiest VPN, a virtual private network designed to keep your information safe and anonymous when surfing the web from big data spies. You'd be shocked how much information your IP address says about your location. Do you want every website you visit having that information? Well, if you'd like to keep your information to yourself, check out virtualshield.com/leakproject program starting at less than $5 a month. They have an opportunity right now where you can even use it for 30 days, 30-day free pass. After that, you can get the discount, 20% discount. Click the link, virtualshield.com/leakproject. All right. So now let's get back to the podcast. What could they do with all those Walmarts that are now closed down? I mean, could they make them into detention-type centers for dissidents, undesirables, you know, politically outspoken individuals, somebody that might throw a wrench in the engine of the beast system, might upset the MFers, the money funders a little too much. Well, now, for those of you out there that got called a conspiracy theorist when talking FEMA camps and Walmart centers, oh yeah, you can just wear that as a badge of honor. Now, I'm not saying that they're going to turn these facilities into FEMA camps or detention-type centers. It's just interesting to read an article about how they actually took a Walmart that was once a Walmart and now is a summer camp for illegal immigrants. So, but you can't go in. You can't see what it looks like because it's, you know, it's such a summer camp. They don't want to clean anything up first before the media goes in there and get their spin on things. No, it has nothing to do with it. Okay, so I was just thinking to myself, not even Congress. Oh wait, this is what the senator says. He goes, not even Congress on the live stream was allowed to see what was going on inside the Americans, and the American citizens are funding the center. That was a comment that he made. So I would like to add my personal opinion. Now, Senator Jeff Merkley to the list of conspiracy theorists. Wear that as a badge of honor, Jeff. You might have thought for yourself. Doesn't it feel good? Halo! So, Senator Jeff Merkley went on Facebook Live to record a former Walmart facility converted to a refugee resettlement center, summer camp, that, in my opinion, has some eerie similarities to what many think of as a possible FEMA-type camp or detention-type center. Oh, yeah. So, I'm going to try to enter a facility in Brownsville, Texas. This is not what I'm going to do. This is what the senator says right here. He says, this is what the senator says. I'm not going to do this. I don't even want to leave my grandma's garage. It's scary out there, folks. So, grandma, those cookies almost done. So, this is what he says. I'm going to try to enter a facility in Brownsville, Texas, run by the Office of Refugee Resettlement. I am told that this former Walmart may currently be housing hundreds of refugee children who have been separated from their parents. I'll leave the link for Facebook, the live stream, also the New York Times article, U.S. Family Separation, Migrant Children Detention. The converted retail store at the southern tip of Texas. This is on the New York Times. Read all about it. It's a little blip here. The converted retail store all the way down southern tip of Texas has become the largest licensed migrant children's center in the entire country. This warehouse for almost 1,500 boys aged between 10 and 17 who were caught illegally crossing the border. The teeming 250,000 square foot facility is a model of border life in Trump-era America, part of a growing industry of detention centers and shelters as federal authorities scramble to comply with the president's order to end catch and release. Okay, my ears are plugged up, so I don't even know what I sound like right now. Did my voice just change? I don't know. Oh my goodness. So, yes, they're adding cots to the sleeping areas. The staff is expanding. And, in a area that is kind of considered, well, according to statistics, let me read this to you. I mean, this isn't from me. This is from the article. Shelters in the near Brownsville have become big business, employing hundreds of residents and bringing abandoned stores, schools, and other buildings back to life in a country where the median household is $34,578 via income. So that would make the percentage, according to this article, living below the federal poverty line is 29.1, far higher than the national poverty rate of 12.7%. Read all about it, New York Times. So, big business. Okay, and it doesn't even have to be a Walmart facility that shut down. I mean, it can be any large facility, folks. I just think it's, isn't it ironic? Don't you think? Oh, yeah. Oh, my goodness. I can't believe I just, that was like, who was that? Alanis Morissette back in the 90s or something like that? Crazy, folks. I'm literally getting harped right now. Thank goodness for my leak project 5G cap with the EMF shielding liner that helps shield EMF frequencies up to 30 gigahertz. Oh, yeah. Will you just look at it? Be excellent to each other, everybody. And go check out that live video via Senator Jeff Merkley. Get him an honorable badge. Conspiracy theorist, you think for yourself. Be excellent to each other, everybody. What do you think about this? And is this the future? Is this, are you looking at this as a good thing, as a bad thing? Do you think that it's moral? I mean, do you think that it's right? I am being completely neutral on this. I want to hear what you think, ladies and gentlemen. I'm just bringing the information to the table. I mean, what do I know? I'm a conspiracy theorist in grandma's garage, and everything is my opinion. Be the change you want to see. No.